Hi everyone, in this video, we will talk about the hypothesis test around multiple linear regression models. And the first one is called t-test, which is for testing individual regression coefficients. So this test is for testing whether or not an individual predictor is helpful to be included in the model. And the second kind of test is called F-test, which is for checking the model as a whole. Like we want to check if the model overall is an effective model. And the third test is called partial F-test. It is used for checking which model is better, like the smaller model is better or the larger model is better. So for the individual t-test, we are actually testing on individual coefficients. Like this beta here is the coefficient of one of the predictors. We are testing whether one single predictor should be included in the model or not, given we have controlled for the other variables in the model. So this is the null and alternative hypothesis test, and we are checking a single predictor should be included or not. And the second test is called overall F-test. It is actually a F-test. I call it overall F-test because we are testing whether the model in general is an effective model or not. So our null hypothesis is all coefficients are zero. All the individual predictors shouldn't be included in the model versus some of the predictors are actually important and should be included in the model. So this is the null and alternative hypothesis in the mathematical format. And we are actually checking the model is effective or not in general. And below here is actually an ANOVA table, which is for showing you like how can we calculate the F value to get the P value for the test. So you can see I listed the model, the source, the sum of the squares from model, from error, and from total, which is the sum of SS model and SSE. So F value is calculated through the mean squared model over the mean squared error. And the partial F test is for model comparisons. So it is for comparing full model with restricted models. I call it restricted models and people call it restricted models because it is a model that is nested under the full model. For example, you can have a model with x1, x2, and x3. That is your full model. And you can also create a model with x1 only. So that model with x1 only is the restricted model. And when you do the partial F test, you are able to check which model is better. And the null hypothesis for this partial F test is that we are checking the coefficients for the omitted terms are all zero. So for this one, we are testing beta 2 equals beta 3 equals 0 against at least one omitted coefficient is not 0. So at least one of beta 2 and beta 3 is not 0. So this is the null and alternative hypothesis in this partial F test. Now, as an example, I'm going to show you how I'm going to do all these kinds of tests on my multiple linear regression models. So first of all, I import the data set, and then I run my MLR1, which is a model on price with mileage, cylinder, doors, cruise, sound, and leather. And my model 2 has all these variables and I added one more variable, which is called make. So we can actually run these four lines and we can see the results here. So you can see for MLR1, and these are called T value and P value. So these are the results about the single T test. So the T test for testing one single coefficient, whether it is zero or not. So for example, for mileage, we are testing beta 1 equals 0 or not. And the p-value here is 1.14 times 10 to the power negative 7, which is a very small number. And you can see it is very significant with 3 stars. The significant codes are here. And also you can see the coefficient for cylinder is beta 2 equals 0 or not. That value is smaller than 2 times 10 to the power negative 16, which is also very significant. So similarly, you can see all the p-values here for the individual t-test for checking each individual coefficient, whether these individual predictors should be included or not. Also for the F test, if I run this model again, we can see there is a line in the very bottom saying F statistic and with a p-value. So this is the overall F test. So this is the p-value, which is very small, and it is rejecting the null hypothesis saying this model has no significant predictors. So this last line here is telling us our model is an effective model. It doesn't mean our model is the best model we can find, but it tells us it is effective overall. Created two nested models. One is a smaller model and one is a larger model, or you can name it, this is my full model and this is my restricted model. And to check on which model is better, or you can think of it as how to do model comparison on the full model and the restricted model, we use partial F test. So you can do it as partial F test function called ANOVA. And we are going to type MLR2 and MLR1, the two models we named here. Remember, MLR2 is our full model and MLR1 is the restricted model. And then we can run that line and we are seeing the results here. They named it as model 1 for the full model, the model with the make variable in there, and model 2 is the restricted model. And they compared the two models on the sum of the squared of residues, and it turned out to be the p-value for the F test is very small. That means we are rejecting the null hypothesis. We are rejecting the null hypothesis saying that make shouldn't be meant the full model is better than the restricted model. This model is better than that model. And then we also talked about a model called model 3. It has interactions, which is a model having mileage, cylinder, mileage times cylinder, and make. So this is our model 3. You cannot do the partial F test on model 3 with any of these two models here because they are not nested models. And now let me make up a model called MLR4. And I'm going to use price as the response variable. I'm going to copy everything in here. And I'm also going to add another variable, which is the squared term of mileage. So like this. When you want to create a squared term, you want to add I and parentheses outside the mileage squared, because you want it to be a new predictor, an added predictor, and to be counted in the model. So this is my MLR4, and now MLR4 is my full model, and MLR3 is my restricted model. So I can run a partial F test on these two models and run that line, and I'm getting a result saying like my full model is here, my restricted model is here, and my p-value is not that small. Very large means we are not rejecting the null hypothesis. Remember, the null hypothesis is that the restricted model is as well as the full model, and we are not rejecting that. So we are thinking, if you want a smaller model, maybe you can use the smaller restricted model here, not adding the squared term of the mileage. And that's all for this video. Thank you.